because it's been a month or so since we talked.
Good evening and welcome to our regular council meeting of Monday, October 5th, 2015. Mr. Aguz, please call the roll.
Coryell.
Here.
Dunbar.
Here.
Saren.
Here.
Stein. Stevens.
Present.
Wilcox.
Here.
Yasna.
Present.
That's six present, Your Honor.
Thank you. Next, we move to the approval of the minutes of the regular council meeting held on Monday, September 21st, 2015. And Councilwoman Dunbar had a couple comments.
Provided them to Tom.
Other than that, I don't think there were any additions or corrections, so I will sign those minutes at the conclusion of this meeting, and the resolutions and ordinances passed at that meeting. Next, we move to personal communications from citizens. If you have a comment you'd like to make to council, please come to the podium, state your name and address and your business before council. No? Ah.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Carla Rautenberg, 3065 Berkshire Road.
Good evening.
The day before yesterday, I was walking from my home up to Zagara's, which is one block, and I picked up these. Now,
what are they?
We have a constant problem with the plain dealer littering our city, and we have ordinances against littering, and I'm sure there's a fine for littering, and we know exactly who is doing it. This was just on the block of East Overlook, pretty disgusting actually, from Cottage Grove to Zagara's. I am really tired of it. It's not as if we ever get any good publicity out of the plain dealer either. So not only do they badmouth us, but they cover our city with these.
Ms. Rautenberg, can you explain to us, those aren't newspapers, right?
These are not newspapers. This is Shop CLE, Shop Cleveland.
Okay.
This is just advertising. And so when we had a problem with them scattering around the city some very, it wasn't a real newspaper, it was like a little sample newspaper because they were trying to sell subscriptions, they said that was their First Amendment right to do that. And that, you know, if we tried to stop them, this was several years ago. And our city manager at the time, Bob Downey, did, let's see, if we called in addresses of vacant houses, then he would call the plain dealer and they would not deliver those to the vacant houses. But this is every house on the street. Nobody else picks them up. I'm the only idiot who picks them up. So we really, you know, this is kind of like a broken windows thing. It really makes our city look bad.
Okay. Well, I'm going to refer this to our city manager and law director to see if there's something we can do.
Well, I would say, Mayor, I know that we've received several calls in our office about these, and my assistant, Jennifer Williams, has been on the phone with almost everybody she can get a hold of at Northeast Ohio Media Group and the Plain Dealer, and so we're working as we can on that issue on their end, and Jim and I will talk about if there are any legal measures that we can take.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for picking them up.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Mr. Mitchell.
Yes. Good evening, everyone in council. My name is Edgar Mitchell. I live at 2025 Goodnow Road, Cleveland Heights, Ohio. I have nothing bad to say. I just came up to thank the council for everything they do and the city of Cleveland Heights, the services that they provide. I did the plain dealer for 12 years, delivered it. And that thing, we used to call that a wrap-up. And the plain dealer make the carriers or the distributors throw those things on people's driveways and stuff. It's going to be kind of hard to stop it. You know, it's great that you picked that up. It's really the distributors, you know, they have no choice. They make you take that extra thing, and they hope that you'll pick it up and that you'll take a subscription from the plain dealer and all this and that. Hopefully we can do something about that, but that's, you know, I did that for 12 years. I used to hate that because, you know, You would deliver the Plain Dealer, the Wall Street Journal, New York Times, Sun Press, and all that, and they put those things on you to throw to try to get people to buy. But anyway, I just mentioned that. But once again, I enjoy living in Cleveland Heights, and I want to thank, you know, the Cleveland Heights police and the people that orchestrate all of the good things that we have. So many bad things happen throughout the city. I'm proud to live in Cleveland Heights.
Thank you.
Thank you. Come back anytime. Anybody else?
Let him have an annual appearance.
Let's move to the report of the city manager, Mrs. Briley.
Thank you, Mayor. I just have one thing to report. Yesterday was the city's first annual Happy 5K. I hope I'm not stealing any of Councilman Coriel's report, but I wanted to just tell council and the viewing public and our visitors tonight how successful that event was yesterday. We had, our goal was to reach 500 registrants for the race itself. I think as of Wednesday, we were a little over 300, and we're very concerned that we weren't going to meet that goal. By yesterday morning before the race, we had surpassed our goal of 500. Two-thirds of those registrants were actually visitors to our city, and so we were excited to be able to showcase the city of Cleveland Heights to them. The merchants were phenomenal in their support of this event, giving away drink specials and food specials. We call it Cleveland Heights Cash. There was over $75, I think, in value of Cleveland Heights Cash to keep people in the district on a Sunday. And if you try to get a cup of coffee at Stone Oven or Phoenix, it took you a little while on a Sunday. We had lots of people in the district. There were businesses on Coventry that participated as well, and so we're looking forward to the event growing. We did learn a few lessons. I got a few great positive emails and a few suggesting some improvement for next year for the motoring public, so we will make sure that we are well ahead of what the road closures will be and make sure that there's some posted detour signage for folks who are looking to get around our wonderful event who aren't looking to join us. But we were very pleased that so many chose to join us yesterday, and it was a great day for an event. I want to thank all of the sponsors and the race coordinator, Western Reserve Racing, is sharing those proceeds with our Cleveland Heights Youth Scholarship Fund. So we're very thankful and looking forward to another successful year next year.
Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, before we move on, so we can just get the race stuff
out of the way. Okay.
It rocked. My colleagues, Mary Dunbar and Ms. Yasnow and I, we did a brisk walk through the route. We were done in under 52 minutes. And so we did.
Sounded like you won a prize or something.
We gave ourselves one. Okay. The Ham It Up prize. We were very pleased with the turnout. We were blessed with a fabulous day, and we even ran the last, 500
Point
feet?
I know exactly how far I had to run. We're good.
But people were very pleased, and there was even a band on the street after we left, mm-hmm. So there was music to keep people engaged, and I can't say enough about this is the kind of event that puts us in the marketplace without any controversy of any type. And there was room for the kids, folks who were maturing in their years, but the best was the guy who ran the 5K in under 30 minutes and was 72 years old. So he was just fabulous. So it was a great day for all of us.
And just to add on, my personal favorite, as you'll probably hear from my report later, was the costume contest. We had the pleasure of awarding costume prizes for the best costumes. First place was a chicken in Batman underwear. Second place was our very own Harry Potter, and third place was a very good pun of a mother-son duo dressed in criminal gear holding bags of cash, and they were bandits on the run. So it was a very fun time for all, and I look forward to next year's run. or a brisk walk in our case.
I'll just add that I walked rather than running, but next year I'll run. So
I'm working toward it, Mary. I'm working.
Does anybody else want to comment now or wait until the report? You're not precluded from commenting
coming
later
twice.
Either. Yeah.
That concludes
okay,
my report.
That.
A happy event.
All right. Next we move to the Clerk of Council and Finance Director, Mr. Raguse.
I have no report tonight, Your Honor.
Okay. We'll move into the committee reports then. The first committee of council tonight is Public Safety and Health. Councilwoman Dunbar.
Thank you, Your Honor. Tonight I present resolution number 114-2015, a resolution declaring the property at 946 Helmsdale Road, Cleveland Heights, Ohio, to be a nuisance and authorizing abatement of the nuisance and declaring an emergency. This residential property has not been maintained, is currently vacant, and is in a state of severe disrepair. Numerous housing code violations on the property since 2012 have not been corrected. This property has adversely affecting the value of neighboring properties. I ask my fellow council persons to join me in authorizing and directing the city manager, certified building official, and director of law to cause the nuisance to be abated legally. Please join me.
Thank you. Resolution 114-2015 has been offered. Are there any comments or questions? Mr. Raguse, please call the roll.
Dunbar.
Aye.
Saren.
Aye.
Stevens.
Aye.
Wilcox.
Aye.
Yazanow.
Aye.
Koryoff.
Aye.
That's 6 ayes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Resolution 114-2015 passes.
I also have resolution number 115-2015, a resolution declaring the property at 2108 Stillman Road, Cleveland Heights, Ohio, to be a nuisance, authorizing abatement of the nuisance and declaring an emergency. This residential property has not been maintained and is in a state of disrepair. Property taxes and housing court fines have gone unpaid. The plan for this one is to scrape and repaint the house and to cut overgrown plants and clear up the yard. This is the usual procedure we used to follow before, back in the day, before demolitions became so popular. So please join me in voting in favor of resolution 115-2015.
Thank you. Resolution number 115-2015 has been offered for passage. Are there any comments or questions? Mr. Raguse, please call the roll.
Saren.
Aye.
Stevens.
Aye.
Wilcox.
Aye.
Yazanow.
Aye.
Coryell.
Aye.
Dunbar.
Aye.
6 ayes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Resolution 115-2015 passes.
I had one other statement.
Okay.
Okay. I just wanted to remind people that this Wednesday, October 7th, is Walker Bike to School Day in Cleveland Heights, and all of our K through 8 public schools are participating in this program. It's very important for kids to get, help them get the kind of exercise they need. Children are supposed to have 60 minutes, an hour of exercise per day, according to the Surgeon General. And there isn't time in the school curriculum to have PE for an hour a day. So walking or biking to school is one way to get the exercises that's needed and to combat or forestall problems down the road with overweight and the consequences of those kinds of things. So watch out for the kids on the 7th as they walk or bike to school.
Thank you. Next, we move to the Planning and Development Committee of Council. We're sitting in for Councilman Stein, Vice Chair, Vice Mayor Stevens.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have nothing to report from this committee. However, I want to recommend that our residents continue to watch the master planning activities that are being supported by Cuyahoga County's Planning Commission and worked on by many residents in the community, as well as staff from the Planning and Development Department. It's a great refresher on who we are as a community and where we want to go, and helping the community build on its future with participation from everyone that has a level of responsibility. So please pay attention as we report on that And if you have the time, watch for the dates as they appear on our website. Thank you.
Thank you for that update. Next, we move to the Administrative Services Committee of Council. Councilman Sarin.
I have nothing to report tonight.
Thank you. Next, we move to the Community Relations and Recreation Committee of Council. Councilman Coryell.
Thank you, Your Honor. I have two pieces of legislation out of the Community Relations and Recreation Committee tonight. First up is Resolution Number 116-2015, proclaiming October 2015 as Domestic Violence Awareness Month in Cleveland Heights. One in four women will experience domestic violence in their lifetime, and children who witness domestic violence are much more likely to abuse their future partners or children. Domestic violence can happen to anyone, regardless of gender. There is a significant number of men who experience domestic violence, as well as women, income, ethnicity, race, religion, age, or sexual orientation. Locally, the Domestic Violence and Child Advocacy Center has provided services to victims of domestic violence for over 35 years. And the City of Cleveland Heights has been in the forefront of the fight against domestic violence, with its police department and prosecutor being routinely commended for their aggressive but fair enforcement of domestic violence laws. So therefore, this resolution proclaims October as Domestic Violence Awareness Month and urges all of our residents to educate themselves on the issue and to encourage and support victims of domestic violence and child abuse. This resolution will be published in the due manner and is declared an emergency. I submit this resolution for consideration and vote.
Thank you. Resolution number 116-2015 has been offered. Are there any comments or questions? Yes.
Yes, I just want to, for those who are interested, as Councilman Coryell had mentioned about the Domestic Violence Advocacy, Domestic Violence and Child Advocacy Center, for those who feel they might benefit from their services or have any other questions, I would encourage you to contact this wonderful organization that provides help throughout the greater Cleveland area. Their website is www.dvac.org. Again, www.dvac.org. And their 24-hour domestic violence helpline can be reached at 216-391-4357. Again, 216-391-4357. Or their family helpline at 216-229-8800. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Ragus, could you please call the roll?
Stevens?
Aye.
Wilcox?
Aye.
Yasna?
Aye.
Coryell?
Aye.
Dunbar?
Aye.
Sarin?
Aye.
That's six ayes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Resolution 116-2015 passes.
Thank you, Councilor Yasnow, for that information about the Domestic Violence and Child Advocacy Center. Next, I have resolution number 118-2015 to join other communities throughout the nation in proclaiming October Breast Cancer Awareness Month. With your leave, Mr. Mayor, I defer to Vice Mayor Cheryl Stevens to describe and introduce this resolution.
Thank you.
Leave is granted. Thank you.
Thank you for your consideration, Councilman Coryell. This is most important to me because it practically devastated my family. Every year, for everyone who knows me, I would spend money to bring my parents to see me from sunny Southern California. They refused to come anytime before the 1st of March or after the 1st of September because they don't think the weather in this state is reliable. So for multiple years, I would spend the money for my mother to come and spend a week or two by herself with me, and then my father to come and spend a week with the both of us together, and then my mother would leave and I got to spend a week with my father by myself. Unfortunately, in 2005, that changed. My mother was diagnosed with one of the most aggressive forms of breast cancer, and she basically had 18 months to live after that. So I've made it my kind of reason to live to find ways to support breast cancer awareness and a way to find the cure. So for many years, I did the 3-day. Beginning in January, I started training. thing, and as long as the three-day was in Greater Cleveland, I convinced all my friends and relatives and even people I didn't know very well to contribute money to help me walk the 60 miles. And in order to train for the 60 miles, I probably walked close to 1,000 miles in the 6 months preparation up until the time the race was in August. But this is most important for many Americans, both male and female, because now that I've been involved in the Susan Coleman Fund and breastcancer.org, I know that men are stricken by this disease as well, and they can be the carriers of the disease to their daughters and sons. And so we must fight this disease. It affects one in every eight women, and most seriously, it also affects those of us who think we're Rubenesque in figure more often than it does our leaner sisters. And so it's important for us to stay in shape, to keep our weight down, to eat right, to support wellness in general, because we want to live the most of our lives that we can. And families should not be denied time with their loved ones that goes beyond 50 to 60 years in families that live 70 to 80 years just because they're unfortunate enough to be stricken with this form of cancer. So I would invite all of my colleagues to support this resolution that my council colleague, Mr. Coriel, has placed on the agenda today, because it is important to fight this cancer with everything we've got. Thank you.
Thank you for those well thought out comments.
I'd like to say that even better than early detection of breast cancer would be prevention. How can you do that? Take care of yourself. Don't get overweight, because women that do have bodies that produce more estrogen, which can fuel breast and uterine cancer. Exercise is also linked to lower breast cancer incidence. So let me repeat, do the right thing. There's no guarantee, but improve your chances of avoiding cancer by taking care of your body for healthy living and to avoid unhealthy consequences.
Thank you. Anyone else? Resolution 118-2015 has been offered. Mr. Ruiz, please call the roll.
Wilcox?
Aye.
Yasno?
Aye.
Coriel?
Aye.
Dunbar?
Aye.
Saren?
Aye.
Stevens?
Aye.
Six ayes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Resolution 118-2015 passes. Councilman Coriel, back to you.
Thank you, Mayor Wilcox. I have no further legislation tonight, but I would like to highlight a few upcoming events of interest to the community as a whole. Early voting starts tomorrow, and Election Day is coming up November 3rd. So first, I'd like to talk about election events. On the ballot is Issue 53, the city's request for a 0.25% increase in the municipal income tax to protect our essential public safety and public works services. We urge you to get the facts on this important levy, which would be the first income tax increase in 36 years, and which does not apply to Social Security or annuities relied upon by senior citizens. By reading the Get the Facts bulletin in the current Focus magazine, which should be arriving in your mailboxes this week, or visiting the city website and clicking the Get the Facts button on the homepage. There are a number of opportunities this month for you to get to know the candidates who want to represent you on City Council or on the school board. All of these events are free and open to the public. Tomorrow night, that's Tuesday, October 6th at 7 p.m., the Noble Neighbors Group will host a Meet the Candidates event to address issues that uniquely impact the Noble area neighborhood. Businesses and institutions at Noble Presbyterian Church, 2780 Noble Road, Cleveland Heights. On Sunday, October 11th, part two of the Grant Deming Neighborhood Candidates Meet and Greet event at Zagara's Marketplace will take place, and that is from 2 to 4. On Wednesday, October 14th, at 7 o'clock, the League of Women Voters Candidates Forum will take place at the Cleveland Heights Community Center. This one will be taped by the city and will be played on Channel 20 at 2 and 7 o'clock p.m. until Election Day, and will also be posted on the city YouTube page. On Tuesday, October 20th, at 11 a.m., there will be a candidate forum in the Senior Activity Center at the Cleveland Heights Community Center. Refreshments will be served. Please note that this one is a daytime event, specifically so that those limited regarding driving at night may safely attend. Finally, on October 27th at 6 p.m., will be the final Whistle Stop Tour event to hear from City Council candidates at the Wine Spot, 2271 Lee Road. In addition to election events, there are lots of other significant things going on in the next few weeks. Tomorrow night, that's Tuesday, October 6th at 5:30 at Phoenix Coffee on Lee Road, you can attend the opening of a children's art exhibit called Big Feelings and support the St. Baldrick's Foundation and their efforts to fund pediatric cancer research. The art has been created by children in the We Hate Cancer Club. This event and the exhibit are in memory of Rebecca Meyer, a recent childhood cancer victim in our community who was good at expressing her feelings and is greatly missed. On Wednesday, October 28th, 6:30 to 9, at Tucker Hall in St. Paul's Episcopal Church, the 2015 Best of the Heights Awards event will take place, presented by Future Heights. This is a great networking opportunity in this city, as local businesses are awarded prizes for having been voted best in the Heights by our residents. Next Saturday, October 10th, you have a choice of a number of outstanding events. First, the Donebrook Watershed Partnership, which celebrates the beauty and function of the Donebrook Watershed and promotes good stewardship of this invaluable resource, and to which the City of Cleveland Heights belongs as a partner, is hosting two walks in the Donebrook Gorge. From 9 to noon is a walk for photographers, and from 2 to 4 is an educational natural history walk led by Dr. Roy Larrick. Details on the walks are at donebrookpartnership.org. Second, the annual Fair Trade Teach-In and Expo will take place on October 10th from 9 to 3:30 p.m. at the Doan Science Center at John Carroll University. Fair trade is a model of trade that incorporates payment of a fair price, environmental stewardship, creating opportunities for economically disadvantaged producers, ensuring no child labor or forced labor, and ensuring good working conditions. As you may recall, we on City Council supported our residents' effort to have Cleveland Heights declared a fair trade city by a resolution that we passed last spring. Third and finally, October 10th is also the date for the annual Coventry Playground Cleanup from 9 to 3 p.m., sponsored by the Coventry PEACE, P-E-A-C-E, which stands for People Enhancing a Child's Environment. We all love the Coventry PEACE Playground and Gardens, but it takes a lot of neighbors and friends to keep it looking good. So students, families, neighbors are all invited to a fall work day, a fun and rewarding day of cleaning, gardening, and repairing. Tools, gloves, lunch, beverages, and guidance are provided. Meet at the top of the hill by the site of the big slide. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to say that I've participated in the PEACE cleanup a couple of times now, and I really enjoy doing it. I feel it's important for our community.
Thank you. Next, we move to the Finance Committee. Vice Mayor Stevens.
I'm introducing resolution number 117-2015. This is a resolution authorizing the reprogramming and reallocation of community development block grant funds. There are a number of important community development projects that need funding in this community. Recently reviewed everything that our Citizens Advisory Committee gave to us. Staff has made some recommendations for changes to previous allocations made by the Citizens Advisory Committee and City Council. The following reallocation of community development block grant dollars is recommended for approval by City Council from staff and the CAC. $5,000 from Fund 208-521131-4803, which is the Neighborhood Mini Grant Fund, and put it into 208-521127060, which is Future Heights line item. The second reprogramming or reallocation of community development block grant dollars is within the scope of the HRRC or Heights Renovation Resource Center Senior Hot Tank Program. This fund was broadened to include some other home improvements that protect the health and safety of seniors, as well as the replacement and repair of hot water tanks. The name of the fund is changed to HRRC Hot Water Tank Program to HRRC Senior Home Stability Program. And that is the most significant change about that program. So the activities undertaken by both of these programs have not substantially changed. However, we needed to reallocate funding and to change the name so it was more inclusive. Mr. Mayor, I'd like to recommend approval of this legislation.
Thank you. Resolution 117-2015 has been offered. Are there any comments or questions? Mr. Agudas, please call the roll.
Yazanow?
Aye.
Coryell?
Aye.
Dunbar?
Aye.
Sarin?
Aye.
Stevens?
Aye.
Wilcox?
Aye.
That's 6 ayes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Resolution 117-2015 passes. Anything else from this committee?
No, this Finance Committee has nothing else for the agenda this evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we move to the Municipal Services Committee of Council. Councilwoman Yazanow.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. I have no legislation for this evening. However, I do want to mention that it is October, which means Halloween, which means candy and candy crawls all throughout the city of Cleveland Heights, my favorite time of year. We have no less, not one, not two, but three different official events happening throughout the city for all of your candy needs, in addition to our October 31st trick-or-treating on Saturday night. First up, we have the Cedar Lea Candy Crawl, which will be happening October 23rd. Then, for those who don't have enough candy, we have the October 28th Cedar Fairmount Halloween Festival from 5 to 7, followed the next evening on October 29th by Coven Treat, which will be sponsored by the Coventry Special Improvement District. I believe we will be having city representatives at all of these fantastic events. There will be candy, there will be games, music, decorating of cupcakes, I believe, at least at the Cedar Fairmount one. So come, bring your kids, bring your costumes, bring an incredibly high tolerance for sugar and good times, and hopefully we will see you there.
Thank you. Next we move to the mayor's report. I had just a couple comments. I will comment on the race on Sunday. It was a great day. The weather was great. We had a really good turnout for our first event. And it was great to see the amount of local businesses supporting this and being sponsors. And of course, the money went to our youth scholarship fund, and that's really the most important part. That's allows children in Cleveland Heights to participate in youth activities if they might not otherwise be able to. So that has been something we've done here for over a decade, and that was really great to see the turnout and the support and see all the young families and a lot of energy up there. And finally, I wanted just to report on a report that council received tonight from our independent finance task force. When council passed a resolution to put the 0.25% income tax levy on the ballot in November, which is now issue 53, we asked our city manager to reach out into the community to those who had some financial expertise to go through our city budgets and to look at some of the past trends and things that might influence our revenues and expenses in the city. And we received that report tonight, and I want to thank Dr. Gus Caius, Mark Weiss, Patricia Ramsey, and Danny Williams for their hard work on this and this really thorough analysis. And they made a number of recommendations to the city, some of which we're doing now and we will probably continue to do more aggressively in the future. But their first recommendation was to pursue an income tax increase, and that one of the reasons they gave was that other cities in our immediate area have reacted to the economic trends that they cited, the Great Recession, the housing market collapse, and the loss of state shared revenue and elimination of the estate tax. So other communities like Shaker Heights and Lyndhurst and South Euclid have already taken those actions to try to increase revenue. And they felt this was a revenue issue, not an expense problem we had. So I appreciate their thoroughness, and there's many other recommendations and observations in the report, and we will publish this and put this online. It's my understanding, so this will be on our website in the next couple of days. So I would encourage those that are getting ready to vote, and I think early voting starts tomorrow, to get the facts. We have information on our website, www.clevelandheights.com. Among those will be this independent finance task force report and some factual information about the importance of issue 53 for the city. And that concludes my remarks. We'll adjourn the meeting at 8:24. Our next meeting will be Monday, October 19, 2015. We are adjourned.